I'm back as a one piece. Don't I look more beautiful than before? Thank you for your prayers. I am very thankful. I am very grateful for being here. I'm sure you heard news. It is very tough and hard time what's happening in the world. Let us pray more than ever. Let's get through this together. Okay? Let me introduce you more beautiful people than I am. These are female influencers in various fields such as advertising and music and dance and tourism. Let's watch. Her name is Rosie. Actually, she's doing a commercial for Shinhan Life Insurance. She dances. Yeah, she just danced like me. Yes. And her name is Louie. She's a YouTuber and sings and dance and travels and doing commercials. Very popular.
Hey y'all.
And her name is Lea, 23-year-old, lives in Seoul. She's a songwriter and singer. And also she was a model for LG Electronic in Las Vegas. And her name is Ima, from Japan. She's model for IKEA in Japan. She does Instagram and Twitter. She has plenty of followers. I heard it's almost 500,000 followers. But let me warn you, don't check it out. What do you think? Have you found something in common? What do you think? They are not real people. They are computer-generated virtual human. Are you shocked? Actually, some guys ask them for a date. Isn't it creepy? There are so many creepy things happening in the virtual world. I'm sure you know more than I do. Virtual currency such as Bitcoin and Ethereum are floating around, and through Roblox and the kids, small kids, and put their games on an online platform and invite friends and meet friends from all over the world. And the middle world, have you heard that? Just like Google and Apple Maps, people actually buy land and sell and created art like a virtual world. Even more shocking, it's a virtual church. People customize the worship service by their flavor, by their interest. And they even get baptized. Let's watch.
I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. So Drumsy, rise up again into new life. To see. I think we should all celebrate Drumsy.
Let's awesome. Give him a
Yay!
Yay! Yay! Drumsy!
Yay! Oh, and the water's gone.
SpongeBob!
Can you believe this? There's no assurance of salvation. There's no Jesus. Yet people visit this site. Why? What do you think of all of this? I am concerned. I'm really concerned. The fact that we are worshiping through YouTube now is also part of the metaverse that escapes the real time and places. More and more people are unable to distinguish the virtual world from the real world. It is a frightening phenomena that this virtual world develops rapidly. Do you think is it okay to be like this? Are we going to be okay? Too much information. Too much changes are flooding like a tsunami. There's no time till we can tell whether that's fake or that's real. Shouldn't we do something? How is your faith? Is your faith real? Do you still have passionate faith in God? Do you still live as a real Christian? Or are you living under the illusion that you are a true believer like a virtual human? Please, please be a real person and real Christian. That's why today's text is very important. First John is a message that makes us realize how important it is to know that truth. Today's text is a warning message. There were false prophets. He warned not to believe everything what they heard. Not everyone who speaks of God is not of God. So we need to discern the spirit. Just as the virtual world confuses the real world, Satan continues to knock us down and deceives us. It makes us mistakenly believe that we are real Christians like those who have been saved. Make sure you are true Christian. Make sure you are real Christian. Make sure you are not a fake. Make sure you attend the true worship service. Here are two things you have to make sure: will you worship, or when you worship, will you listen to God's word? First, make sure you attend the true worship. 1 John chapter 4, verse 1. Let's read together. Dear friends, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirits to see whether they are from God, because many false prophets have gone out into the world. The pandemic has given us many, many choices. In terms of worship, we have a choice for whom we listen to, when we worship, and where we worship at. Of course, there are many, many great churches, many great pastors and preachers. But I want you to know that there are false pastors and false preachers and false teachers too. I hope you should be able to distinguish the real from the fake as you listen to the word. So pay attention to these three facts when you listen to the sermon or when you attend the worship. First factor, be aware whether they teach the Bible. Do you remember 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16? Yeah, I memorized that. All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching and rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. The Bible was written under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. So each character, vowels, and noun in the Bible is the word of God. It is wrong to skip verses to support his or her claim. Without the Bible, we have nothing to believe. Because there is a Bible, we believe in God, and we believe in Jesus, and we believe in heaven. Amen? Amen. So make sure they teach Bible. The second element to be aware of, the message of salvation through Jesus Christ. Make sure they have message of salvation. Let's read 1 John chapter 4, verse 2 and 3. This is how you can recognize the Spirit of God. Every spirit that acknowledges that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God. But every spirit that does not acknowledge Jesus is not from God. This is the spirit of Antichrist, which you have heard is coming and even now is already in the world. So make sure that when you listen to the sermon, as you listen to the word, the message of salvation through Jesus Christ is clearly delivered every time. Got it? Third factor is be aware of whether they only emphasize on prophecy and spiritual gift. Especially in times like uncertain like nowadays, people are startled and want to know how the future holds. That's why people easily fall to false teachers and fortune tellers. Nothing wrong with the revelation and having spiritual gift. If they pray and encourage someone with the gift they received, why would we call it heresy? They claim only the revelation and gift they have received are authentic. And under the guise of asking for material things, we're forcing you to live with their groups and in groups. They create fear. So make sure you are not listening to those sermons or attend those services. So first, we have to make sure you have to attend true worship. And then second, and make sure you are true Christian. Do you remember the parable of wheat and weed in Matthew chapter 13 verse 30? Let's read. Let both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, first collect the weed and tie them in bundles to be burnt. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn. Here, can you tell which one is wheat and which one is weed? Since the wheat and weed grow together, it is very difficult to tell the difference without looking at the roots, unless you are an expert. Because wheat and weed are very similar, you may pluck wheat to pull weed. Here, left one is wheat. Same as we couldn't tell the virtual human as a real human. Can you tell who are the real people out of these eight people? Look at very carefully. If you said number one, he's the only one. Let me show you more example. This image was from 2011, a psychological science paper. One was drawn by a four-year-old child and one by abstract artist Hans Hofmann. Which one do you think is done by Hans Hofmann? Right one is correct. Was that hard? How about this? Which one do you think is genuine? Well, which one is fake? What? 명품 or 짝퉁? Yeah, it is hard to tell. Right one. That's right. Even within the church, there are true Christians and fake Christians. They are growing together and coexist. We cannot tell who are true Christians. But the Bible teaches us that there will be a final judgment at the end of the world. The wheat will be tied up and thrown into fire. The wheat enters the master's barn. In other words, everyone can be a church member as they come to church, but not everyone can go to heaven. Jesus has to be in your life. Be the grain. Be a true believer who has accepted Jesus as a Lord. I know it's not easy to live as a true Christian, same as the wheat grows with the weed. There are times love can be distorted. The truth can be distorted. There are times people do not understand your heart. I want you to know that it's a training of your faith. God knows your heart. More so, keep your faith. Don't be discouraged. The harder it gets, the tougher it gets, the more lonelier it gets, cling to God more than ever. You must not fall. Just say it. Just shout out. I shouldn't be like this. I have to keep my faith. I believe in my God. This is what real Christian does. Virtual world, virtual currency, virtual human, virtual church, they are all fake. No. Be a real person. Be a real, real Christian. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us Jesus Christ. There are so many temptations out there, and sometimes we just fall for the temptation and we cannot even tell what is real and what is fake. Father, let us be a true Christian. Let us be a real Christian who accepts Jesus Christ as a Savior and Lord. Father, and let us more glorify your name and let us share the gospel to the whole world. Now I'm asking your abundant blessing in the name of the Father and Son and Holy Spirit to every one of us here, as well as all our people throughout the world and our churches and our countries and all the medical staff taking care of patients right now, and all the missionaries, ministers spreading your word throughout the world, all the American soldiers fighting for peace and freedom throughout the countries, bring them home safely. Amen.